It can be tough keeping all your tasks and notes organized throughout the week and still getting things done. I'm creating multiple videos a week, podcasts, doing administrative tasks, and trying to plan for the future, as well as household chores, taking out the garbage, and things like that. So in this video, I'm going to share the 5 apps that I use to keep track of all the to-dos and my notes, why I split them across seemingly redundant apps like Things and Reminders or Apple Notes and Bear, some specific features of those third-party apps that make it worthwhile, and maybe this video will give you some ideas on how you can organize your tasks and notes. This way you never lose track of anything. When it comes to developing a task or reminder system, I fully believe in putting everything in an app rather than trying to hold anything in your head. And so I actually have 5 different apps I use throughout the week: Things, Reminders, Bear, Notion, and Apple Notes. Now, some of you may think, why do you have double of these, like Things and Reminders, or Bear and Apple Notes? Well, I hope to explain that throughout this video, but the first thing we should cover is what is required for my task and note system. But if I'm gonna use an app on my iPhone, iPad, or Mac to keep track of things and notes, these are 5 pretty much non-negotiables that I need from those apps. Number 1, every system needs to be rock solid. I never have to worry about losing a task, some project disappearing, or there being sync issues between my phone and my Mac. Which leads me to number 2, I need these apps on every platform. I need to be able to quickly input on my iPhone, manage things on my Mac, and also manage things on my iPad if that's where I'm working. Number 3, and this might seem like a weird requirement, but I really want these apps to have good design. Good design usually means good user interface, and some of them are even fun to use. And so I'm going to talk about the whimsical nature of some of these apps. Yes, I even think a task app can be whimsical, but at the very least, it needs to have good design, just visually, aesthetically pleasing. Number 4, it needs to be easy to input information, whether it's notes or tasks. I don't want to have to think about putting something in, I just want to do it. And also organizing things. A lot of times, some more powerful apps can get really cumbersome and complicated, and I have found myself spending hours in those kinds of apps where I'm actually not getting things done. I'm just doing things to organize the things. And number 5, if I'm gonna use a third-party app, ideally it should have some unique or special features that I can't get in the stock apps already on my iPhone. And many of the stock apps have gotten really, really good, like Apple Notes and Reminders, which is why I still use them for some tasks. But if I'm gonna use a third-party app, ideally it offers something above the stock applications that makes it worth having on my phone. So let's talk about my main task app, which is Things. Things is a one-time purchase. You do have to purchase separately for the iOS version and the Mac version, but there's no subscription, and I just absolutely love Things. You know, I talked about whimsical design being one of the requirements, and Things has it. Just creating a new task, the little simple animations, just in clicking that plus button, not only is it super fast and easy, but it looks great doing it. There's lots of nice touches like swipe gestures, like if I want to swipe on the task I just created and then delete it. Everything is fast, easy to do, and I love the organization system that Things offers. I typically stick in the today view, which shows me the tasks that have a due date of today. But you see there's an inbox just for throwing tasks and then organizing them later. And then you can separate different projects, or Things calls them areas, and then projects within areas. And I do like some organization there. But Things is also incredibly powerful. I'm gonna go over to my Mac and show you Things here as well. If I wanna create a new task, I can quickly title it, and then there's a notes section. And one of the unique features to Things is it actually supports markdown. So I can italicize things, I can have bulleted lists, and I can also do subtasks, all within a single note. So lots of flexibility for the notes that I'm keeping and subtasks. Then I can set this task for a due date. Selecting today, I can choose a future date. There's also a someday option where if you don't have a specific time or date, but you just wanna make sure you get to it eventually. And you can add a reminder. So I can say, let's do a reminder for 10 a.m. I can click this arrow down here and move it to a specific project or area. And then if I click the 3 dots, I get even more options. I can duplicate this, convert it to a project, and even the repeat section, which I use pretty often, lots of options here. Time repeats like daily and weekly, or after completion. You can choose how often, whether or not to add reminders and deadlines to the task, and you can do things like flag and tag the task for even further organization. If I click away, this will collapse, and you'll see it's not a part of a project right now, but I can also just drag it under this area, and now it's organized. So if I go to that area here, I can view all the tasks at once. Things also has really powerful shortcuts integration. You can add tasks using the voice assistant with or without shortcuts. But you can see all these individual actions for shortcuts automation, just really powerful. Makes it easy if you have like templates you want to create whenever you do a new project. You can create a bunch of tasks quickly, organize it all with the shortcut actions. Just lots of flexibility here. And while I typically don't have my calendar and tasks in the same place, I do like how Things allows me to put some events here in the today view. It's not everywhere, so if I go to like one of my projects, I don't see those events. But when I'm planning my day and any tasks that might be time sensitive, I do like to see what work events I have in my calendar so I can plan accordingly. It also looks great on the iOS and iPad version where I have just my very discrete events at the top and then my tasks underneath. And when I'm done with a task and I just check it off, again, just beautiful little animations. Things also has great widget options. Here's the Things widget down here in the bottom left. And I can actually tap to mark something as done right from the widget. So if I tap my newsletter, that's going to mark it as done. It syncs quickly. And you can see on my Mac, it synced literally in just seconds. That rock solid syncing and reliability is a big deal. So I absolutely love Things for all those reasons. A lot of people ask me about OmniFocus, and OmniFocus is a great app. OmniFocus has been around for a long time. It's available on all platforms. And if you want the most granular control over your tasks and projects, OmniFocus is probably the one to get. What I had found though is I'd tried OmniFocus several times and I loved all the options, but I often got stuck in that organizing and putting things into the system mode and couldn't make it work to actually get things done long term. I like things that are quick and light to use, and OmniFocus can be that, but it actually was just way too many options for me. Now, I know lots of people who use OmniFocus to great effect, but for me, I prefer something like Things, and I use reminders for tasks as well. I know this seems redundant, but here's why. Number one is collaborative lists, so I do have some shared tasks lists, and you can share lists easily, not just with iCloud Family, but anyone with Apple devices. And when it comes to what do I put in reminders versus Things, all like the normal home tasks, like doing Wordle every day, wanna make sure I don't miss that, taking out the trash, checking the water softener salt. These are the things I use reminders for. Why don't I just put that in Things? Well, for these kinds of tasks, they're usually very time sensitive, meaning I'm gonna do it on a specific day and a very specific time, like taking out the trash. And I don't want to see those tasks until it's time to do them. Now, I know apps like OmniFocus have that specifically as a feature where you won't see a task in your app until it's time to do it. But again, it's just too complicated for me. This dual system of using reminders for time-sensitive, personal, and home tasks, and then using Things for my actual work, it actually works for me. Now, reminders has gotten really powerful as well, don't get me wrong. Adding a task, you have tons of flexibility. You can add a location to a task, which then allows you to do automations and reminders based on that. The custom repetition for reminders is really powerful now. You can add URLs to reminders easily by drag and drop from your iPhone. And you can even drag text message conversations onto a reminder, and clicking that bubble will bring you right to that text conversation. You can also do grocery lists and reminders, tag tasks. You have that today view. You can flag things. Listen, it's really powerful. And anytime I have to do a personal reminder and I'm going to use the voice assistant on my phone or my watch, it's going to go directly to the reminders app. And it's super solid. I know it's going to remind me at the time. And it's really useful for that hyper quick entry, things that I don't want to see until it's time to do them. So yeah, I live this weird dual lifestyle of using both reminders and Things, but it works for me. I usually don't have reminders open constantly on my Mac. I'll just keep this Things window open because that's what I'm working on during the day. And then when it's time to either check off a reminder, I do have this reminders widget. Usually it's in a stack, which I have this size stack right here, and I'll have like podcasts and then Things and reminders all one right after another. And I can check off the reminder right from the widget, which is really cool. So those are my work tasks and personal tasks with Things and reminders, but I also use Notion for a quasi task project planning system. I have two Notion workspaces. One is the videos that I make for my personal YouTube channel. And the second workspace is Primary Technology, which I share with my co-host Jason Aten. You should definitely listen to Primary Technology. I'll put a link to the YouTube channel above, or the podcast links are down below. But Notion is where we plan episodes for Primary Technology. I put my notes and links here for what we're going to be talking about in each episode. And I use Notion for this because I actually like the Kanban style view. And we also have some pages here where we keep information like just docs for the podcast, branding, things like that. And I also use Notion for my personal video tasks. Again, because I like the Kanban style, moving things from ideas to in progress to completed. Yes, these are all the ideas I have right now. If you see any videos you like, let me know down in the comments. And I'll make notes that I'm actually referring to this right now on an iPad off camera. This way I'm making sure to say everything I want in the video, which I know this could live in Things or reminders as well, but I just like having these ideas and a very specific place to manage podcast episodes and video tasks. And Notion works well for that. I do have kind of a love-hate relationship with Notion. It is a bit cumbersome. Notion is not really whimsical or beautiful design, which I would put Things in that category. And it took me forever to realize I can actually link text just by selecting text here in a Notion doc. And if I have a URL on my clipboard, I could just tap paste, and that makes hyperlinked text in Notion. Despite all the tools that Notion gives you, even in the mobile app, it just was not immediately obvious, so that was kind of annoying. And aside from my actual full episode notes, which are here in Notion, I don't typically manage a lot of text here, because even if I wanted to select this and then move it somewhere or format it, Notion is just more cumbersome than using Markdown or a plain text editor, even in something like Apple Notes. So it's just very specific use case for video planning and podcast episodes. So those are Things, Reminders, and Notion, kind of my triforce for project and task management. But what about notes? For 99% of all my notes, I use the Bear app on all my Apple devices. I absolutely love Bear from its design to whimsical nature, like flexibility with Markdown. It has great apps for every platform, iPad, iPhone, and Mac. Rock solid syncing. There's also lots of different themes, so you can choose how it looks, you can choose the fonts. I use Bear Pro, so you have access to all of these. Lots of different app icons if you prefer to change that. But the thing I love most about Bear is I can just quickly throw text at it, either via a shortcut or creating a new note. Of course, it supports Markdown, so I can quickly bold and italic as I'm typing. Bulleted lists are done really well. And the organization method is not technically folders, but it's actually tags. And I prefer this because that means I can have a note in multiple places. Right now, you see this is under my podcast heading and then secondarily primary tech. But if I want to have this in my Beard FM videos folder, you can actually add multiple tags and multiple subtags so this note can appear in multiple places. I can also pin this note to the top if it's important, and it will appear on my All Notes view as well. If you don't like writing in Markdown, Bear also supports rich text entry, so you can do bold, italic, all those kinds of things. Headers are easy, you can do separators. You can even add tables and images. Bear is incredibly powerful like that, plus it gives you cool things like word counts easily in this info tab. You can actually jump to different sections if you created different headers using the table of contents view, which is pretty sweet. And you can also do backlinks, so if you wanted to link a word or phrase to another note in your Bear documents. If you use Notion or Craft, you're familiar with this, that double bracket now created a new note that's embedded within the first note. And I can also put this in a different tag or folder wherever I would like. Just super powerful stuff. Another awesome feature is it's great at handling rich text, Markdown, and even HTML. When I format podcast show notes for primary technology, I actually do it in HTML, and you can see Bear does a nice job of color coding it and just visually parsing it so it's easy to read. Not only that, you can have a mixture of Markdown, HTML, and rich text all at once, and it will also format Markdown so it looks like rich text, but it's still Markdown underneath. Then if you want to edit it, you see the Markdown right there. Another favorite feature I have of Bear is I can select Markdown or rich text, and when I right-click it, and I can copy this as rich text, or as Markdown, or even as HTML. And now when I paste it, it'll give me that same information, but now formatted as HTML. Really powerful. There's also great widgets for your iPhone and iPad. This is actually a Bear note tag right here. I can jump into one of those notes. And again, I have everything right here, like my table, embedded images. I can quickly enter more text here. And you see, even on mobile, you have all these formatting tools, including tables, checklists if you want to do to-dos in Bear, adding images from directly from the camera, photos, even scanning documents. Bear is incredibly powerful behind a simple and beautiful design. And not to mention, if you like shortcuts, Bear has a ton of shortcuts actions, just so flexible, really powerful. I actually end a lot of my shortcuts for my podcast show note formatting with a Bear note. For instance, my primary text shortcut, which I talked about in a previous shortcuts video, I'll link that above and down below, formats a bunch of links that I had for show notes, puts the boilerplate text in, and then I actually have a Bear note creation action at the very end. So I can run this shortcut and it will automatically create a Bear note. And all of this was generated automatically from that shortcut. I have the HTML here and I can reformat this into rich text. It's just powerful, flexible, everything I want in a note app. But there are some rare occasions where I do use Apple Notes, which has also gotten really powerful and getting even more updates with iOS 18, like those collapsible section headings, more colors. And the main thing I use Apple Notes for is collaboration. When I want to share a note with someone, I will likely put it into Apple Notes. That's something Bear does not do. So like right here, I have our pool care and operation, and I've shared this note with my wife, and so we can both take a look at it. When my kids create a birthday list, I'll do a shared note with family. But it doesn't support Markdown, and it isn't good at HTML, so those are kind of non-starters. It will do like bullet lists if you start with an asterisk or a dash. And it is powerful too, like with tables, embedding different media, adding links, and you have all your rich text tools here. But there's not a lot of color themes or options. I don't find it whimsical like Bear. I will give Notes credits for its shortcuts actions. Lots of options there, and I've done many videos having Apple Notes actually be the ending point of different shortcuts. But without Markdown support and not easily handling different kinds of text like rich, HTML, and Markdown all in one document, Bear wins for me, especially with its beautiful design, its themes, and I think whimsical nature. Now, this video is mainly about task and note apps, but Fantastical is another huge part of my productivity workflow. But I actually have an entire video dedicated to Fantastical, so I'll link that down in the bottom and I'll put it right up here. And while you're here, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. If you have app recommendations, whether it's tasks, notes, or anything else, leave comments below this video. I also have a different video where I did like 24 little known iPhone apps and 40 something iPhone widgets. I'll leave links to those videos down in the description and I'll put one right up here if you want to learn more about that. And iOS 18 public betas are coming out, plus their full release this fall, and so I'll be covering them all right here on the channel, the new features for tvOS, iPad, macOS Sequoia, and more. So stay locked in, hit that bell icon so you don't miss a video. Thank you as always for watching. I'll catch you next time.